Thank you, Big D.
A blast from the past, our old buddy Donald.
Mm-hmm. Let me give you some, let me show you some love. And some me. Thanks, man. Welcome to the party. How's everybody doing?
Well, I have to give you an update. Jimmy Ryan, who was on the show last night, the guitar player and musical director for Carly Simon. He played guitar on John Entwistle's solo record, Mad Dog, has a book out. And Sula Cinte bought it today. Yeah.
That's great.
I think so, too.
That's.
I bet there's going to be some... That guy, I don't think, is going to hold back.
He's not holding back.
He's not holding back.
He's not holding back.
So you've got to get some juicy juicies in there.
Yeah, that's going to be a good one. I'm looking forward to getting that one myself. But, hey, listen, you know, this is the quality guest that we try to bring to you here on the show.
Oh, he was great.
He was fantastic.
We already have him booked for, she got it on Amazon. We already have him booked for a part two.
Yeah, we've got Jimmy booked for, because I was so happy to meet somebody else that's played with Entwistle to talk about John and, you know, I mean, with the album coming out and all that.
But how cool is it?
And we wound up, guy was in the Critters, played with old Carly.
L.A. May's favorite band.
Yeah,
the
L.A.
Critters.
May's favorite band. And played with Carly Simon for 21 years.
Yeah, but the thing is, they worked together before she was a singer.
I know, that's a weird, in New York.
In New York. Well, her father was Simon and Schuster.
Yeah.
A New York publishing house.
It was, if you missed last night's episode, it was really good. I mean,
Chris Chanel said great show last night.
Yeah, it was fun. It was fun.
Sue said, this is the place. Oh, and we have to meet Mr. OG popped in. He hasn't been
well,
in a while.
Well, OG.
Hey, Frank Feeney.
How's it going, bro? How's it going? Are mics too hot?
Why? Did somebody say something?
No, but it looks like they're clipping on my side. Hey! I hope I didn't wake your cat up again.
No, I don't think they're too hot. They're loud.
Well, it's us, isn't it?
But last night, Jimmy thought I didn't have my own microphone. And Lenny is the one that said, you know, I need my own microphone.
Okay, so are we balanced, guys? Are we nice and balanced?
No, we're very unbalanced.
Really? I think if we weren't balanced perfectly, we would be dead.
Yeah, but I'm just talking about as human beings.
That's what I'm talking about.
Richard Wing says it was absolutely a great episode.
Yeah, great show. It was a great show. And I heard from my good buddy, Rich Redman.
Yes,
for those of you, so those of you country fans that like Jason Aldean.
It's his drummer.
Yeah, it's his drummer. And we're not going to talk about the gloomy shooting and, you know, that whole thing. But
I forgot all about that.
But Rich, well, I might have to ask him about it privately.
There's been so many shootings since then.
Yeah, but not too many concert shootings. There was what's his name's, the rappers where the people got killed in the, getting crushed.
What?
But no,
oh, yeah.
Yeah, come on, what's his
name?
Yeah.
I forgot his name.
Oh.
But I know he's Kylie Jenner's boyfriend.
See, I don't want to holler out the wrong name.
Kylie, the little one.
Oh, Kylie, I don't follow her.
You don't follow any of them.
No,
but
oh.
Listen to what they did. You know how they, Tom Heinisch says good balance.
Okay,
you know how the
it's coming from you, bro. I was bragging on you last night, Tom. Go ahead.
Kardashians, it was their last season of Keeping Up with the Kardashians.
Yeah, that's
because they were like on what, E or something?
Yeah, they were on E.
Now, all of a sudden, Mama Jenner went and made a deal with
Hulu,
and it's just the Kardashians. So, man, she knows how to make that money. Okay, wait, what? Pat Romano says you need to get Angus to line up Ronald Howden from Nectar again.
Again? You want Ron Howden on the...
Which one? Was that the guy we've had on a couple of times?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, he was great.
Yeah, he was great.
We've had him on twice, though, I think.
Have we had him on twice?
Yeah, we have.
Well,
we've had him on twice.
Yeah. Okay. Well, listen, I'm not opposed to having people.
We got fresh blood coming our way, people.
Yeah, man. We got new stuff happening. We got some great guests coming up, which Angus will tell you about on Monday.
And we have our new segment on Wednesday.
Our new segment on Wednesday. Oh, I should dial up the segment header.
Not tonight, but next Wednesday.
Yep, a week from tonight it starts. Look, do I have...
I personally can't wait for this.
You know, somebody in the control room is going to get into a lot of trouble with me here.
Well, you know what? Your microphone, what?
No.
Who? Who's going to get in trouble with you?
Because they're supposed to put up this...
I'm not in the control room.
This promo,
so
not
Remy,
you.
You're in
not
trouble.
You. Yeah, that's going to be Wednesdays. Cool, right? Because TJ and Pearl stroll up and down the beach.
Yeah, they do every day.
And I mean, if you want to laugh, you should follow TJ's Facebook, because I mean, he's just talking to anybody with Pearl. So we were watching, and Pearl, if you see her limping, it's, you know, she was injured many, many years ago. So she kind of walks.
Got hit by a car.
Yeah, she kind of walks.
He said 32. She was 32.
And she was walking towards this little girl. I guess there were a lot of weddings yesterday.
Yes.
And she was walking towards this little girl. The girl started screaming like
she... And she stops.
She's probably got bird trauma now.
Yeah,
forever.
Pearl, stop. But it was cool because they had conch shells lined up like where the aisle would be, you know?
Yep. And so they got married on Drew's birthday.
Yes.
Well, yeah. Okay. So... what else? Okay, request. This was a tough week, guys. I mean, I'm gonna have to go back into the archive and pull out some more tapes and digitize them. The only problem is I'm in the middle of digitizing the Entwistle collection, so it's probably gonna be a little while till I get around doing any more of the archaic rat race stuff. You know, archaic. You know, from the prime days.
This is how you know someone really pays attention to your show.
Uh-oh.
Pat Romano said about Ron Howden, The second was a follow-up to a glitched episode.
I remember that. I was going to say something like that, and you're absolutely right, because he was glitching all over the place.
Oh, my God.
But he was on a couple of...
Pat knows this.
Because Pat's...
He pays attention.
He's the rock and roll library, man.
And he also says the new Wednesday program will be great. He can't wait.
Yeah, it's going to be fun. Because, I mean, that guy's got, you know... He's just... We've been talking for the past couple of days, been sending me different things. I mean, that's going to be funny. And I think, you know, for me and anybody that's been to Florida, you sort of take the Florida thing for granted. But there's a lot of people that watch the show, different parts of the country that maybe they're landlocked. Maybe they've never seen Florida, certainly not Key West.
Key West is totally different than Orlando or Miami.
Yes. Key West is like...
It's
more like
New Orleans, kind of.
It's kind of like, yeah, more like where Lenny lives than where, it's not quite that remote, but I mean, it's more...
Yeah, but I'm talking about the partying that goes on
there. Oh, well, and you don't think they party in Antigua?
Yeah, but...
Just look at Lenny.
Key West, I mean...
Key West is a destination, without question.
Yes.
It's the southernmost... Point is it the southernmost point in the United States?
Yes, it is. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because we went and saw that thing.
Yes, we did. We took a picture.
And it's going to be fun because people from all over the world come to Florida, obviously because it's Florida. But there's a certain kind of person that does Key West, very special, usually European, quite eccentric.
European.
It's going to be fun.
Yeah, or people who just want to,
Just want to get
the hell
out of Dodge.
It's like the tropical Vegas.
Yeah.
Without neon lights. What happens there stays
there. And no gambling? Except walking down the street, you're gambling with your life? No.
But there's we went there and ate at that restaurant, Blue Haven.
Blue Haven.
Someone told us to go there. And it was so cool because we had, not Remy, it was our dog, two dogs before Remy, Beanie. And we brought him
with... there?
Yeah, and we sat outside, and they had, colorful lights strung. It was nighttime, and all of a sudden, roosters come walking up around the table, and Beanie's laying on the ground. It's like dirt ground, but it was...
Yeah, and I know, I can imagine that we did not bring Cody there because...
No, Cody didn't go there.
No, I know, but I mean, if he saw roosters, that we would have been on our asses.
Well, not when he was...
He was in Florida.
And Conrad Phillip,
hey!
Welcome to the show. She says very colorful about Key West. That's right.
Oh, extremely colorful.
And that's why we are sending TJ a shirt to bring around to some of the shops in Key West.
Well, no, it's not. We're sending TJ a shirt because... Because
he's the man. Well, Fader's the man.
Fader is the man. Well, anyway, I said something about getting out of Dodge. Very funny. I'm listening to, I'm digitizing. There's certain shows that I have from that were already mixed and so on and so forth, and so that I want to pull different versions of songs off of it. And today I put in the Dodge City tape, and you might have heard me talking to Jimmy last night about Dodge City with the eight people. I never realized. I should probably. The only way I could play it for you is if I qualified it first, and I can't do it now because it's still in one big long contiguous session. But I'll play you the part. I told you there were six people standing in the front and one guy in the back who was jumping up and down, wiggling back and forth, and the seventh guy was running from one out of the darkness and just dropping on the floor and skidding to a stop. And so I get to Had Enough, which is the song that we were playing when this was all going on. And John, those of you who've seen our show, a lot of times he's not looking out at you guys. He's looking at me or across the stage. But that's, that's it. He's sort of one of these guys. And the... these people, we're playing flat out roaring music. Who's songs, John's songs. And I'm telling you, there's eight people in this place.
And the reason why, though, is because it got booked like 2 days before the show.
Right, because we
had
no place
advertisement.
We were recording and we didn't want to stop. Our agent, bless his.
Our agent. He made it up.
He did make it up. No, that's true. He did make it up. He took care of us. He's one of the good guys from Paradise. I don't know if he's still with them. But anyway, so we have this huge two-week hole in the middle of the tour. And it starts in, like, Kansas. So, okay, that's good. Not. So we decided we would just play anywhere so we could keep recording and keep, you know, running through the act. And so today, the dat that I pulled out was Dodge City. And it's weird enough, and I'll play it like on a Anything Goes one of these Wednesdays, maybe next Wednesday. We're playing because we're recording an album, and we're like, you know, digging in, and it's loud, and this was a big room, and it was really sounded great, and we had a really good night, except there was nobody there. So the band's like, bow, and then you hear, like, six people clapping. And so today, because I didn't just listen to, in the middle of Had Enough, where it's life is for, what, you know, that whole harmony part in there. Takers never giving. We can't sing because we're laughing so hard at these.
But not John.
No, not John. John doesn't see it going on. Right. I mean, John's usually either.
And he's like, what are they laughing at?
And he's starting to get. He doesn't like to not be part of the joke. You know what I mean? What are you guys laughing at? And of course, he thinks we're laughing at something. That, you know, he's looking to see. So. And I mean, I'm telling you, I'm going to play this for you because it's when you hear, you know, I'll qualify, like I said, because if you heard it on a record, you'd be, those guys suck. Why did they put that out like that?
But that was your best show.
Oh, it was our
just
best
not
show.
That song.
Just not the vocals. And the funny thing is, the music goes right along like it was programmed. And I mean, it was, I couldn't breathe. I said, Laura, you got to come here. So she came into the control room and it played through and we laughed at it. And it was like, it's hard to believe that it was that, right? So at the end of the song, John comes over and goes, what's so funny? And we said, you know what?
Look at the audience, John.
And, you know, like, it's like,
there's
what?
Like six
what
people.
Look, you see those people standing in front of you? Look at them during the next song. And he was the one, I didn't even realize it, because now I'm listening to the whole tape so I can hear the stuff that's going on between songs. Because there's not 10,000 people there, we don't have to worry about what we do. So we're just talking back and forth on the stage, kind of like it's a rehearsal, right? And so you can hear him say on the tape, and I promise you, I will edit this down so that you can hear it all. He says, I didn't catch it exactly right, but he said that the guy was spawning, the guy in the back that was doing this. He's spawning. And when I heard it, it just brought that whole trip so flooding back on me. That was spawning. You're in for a treat.
Yeah.
And so what else? I started a group for the album, for the Oxumed album. In case anybody wants to ask anything.
Oxumed, not...
Oxumed.
Oxumed.
Rarities, Oxumed.
Oxumed.
You know, if you... Whatever. Who knows why you might want to join that group.
I get it. Who knows?
What? Who said what?
I get it. Who knows?
Well, anyway.
Well, now, Chris Chanel just admitted a little guilty pleasure that he's indulging in.
Guilty pleasure?
Yes. He says, tell. I hate to admit this, but I've been watching that Tommy and Pam 8-part series.
Really?
Tonight is the 6th episode. I think it's a little far-fetched. I don't know about that. I haven't seen it,
but it's far-fetched? It wouldn't be far-fetched if it was in a porn shop. So... I know a little bit about
that. Yeah, we actually saw the actual,
yeah,
you know,
we saw the actual...
tape.
We were gifted...
The sex tape.
We were gifted an original copy.
That's right.
And it was like, Tommy, really? But anyway, yeah.
Who knew?
Who knew? Who knew?
Where does he hide that thing?
Where does he hide? Yeah. And,
okay, well...
So, well, what?
We've got some songs for our people.
Oh,
tonight.
We got songs.
Children of the Lawn.
My lawn people.
Okay, Mark Visconti, he could not find any Robin Trower.
I couldn't find, I mean, I have it somewhere because I have everything.
But he's been working on the Entwistle album, so he could not take
yeah, so
the
I
time.
Just couldn't digitize it. So I, because there was a whole, I picked, because we just lost Gary Brooker, rest in peace, I picked a couple of Procol songs. Because somebody requested a Procol song, which I have, and I found another one. So I figured that's close to Robin Trower as I'm going to get in short order. And then who asked for UK?
That would be Anthony Gisondi, who I don't see in here.
Well, that's all right. We'll play it anyway.
Well, the other
you know
people
what?
Will like it.
It'll be there, and he can always watch it. Well, so he can always watch it back. You know, that's why we do it. That's why we leave them up there. It's not like the old days when you had to watch a television show, and if somebody said something, you didn't get to rewind
right.
it.
Well, because Sue missed the show last night.
That's right.
And if you noticed, I mean, Sue was not in the room.
Yep.
And she said that she was at a wedding yesterday because it was 2/22/22, and the wedding was at 2/22.
Yeah.
But she watched the show today, and that's when she saw Jimmy, and she went on Amazon and bought his book.
Which is very cool, and thank you for that, because that's, you know, that's important. And let's see, what else? Before I play this first track... And don't forget about Mondays, right? Here's Mondays. We have a Monday. We have a Monday ad. Look at that. Rock and Roll in Review with Brad Congress. I don't know if you saw our Three Kings episode this Monday, this past Monday. But I learned stuff I didn't know. And it's, you know, music is a cool thing. It's the only language that everyone in the world
okay,
can read if they know it. Okay,
do
wait.
Do you have any UK in the...
I have UK.
Okay, Mark. Mark said, I asked for UK if you don't have Robin Trower. Okay,
oh.
I wrote it down.
Okay, UK. Okay,
UK. We got some
well,
UK
think I, and
for
you, think
Mark.
I didn't, you think I didn't have UK? You think I wasn't going to do that for you?
And
now?
We have some Procol Harum.
All right, so what do we want to start with?
Actually... Just what? In case you guys
oh,
don't
no.
know.
Oh, no! Don't! Not yet! Wait, no, 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 no!
Never mind.
What? No, go ahead. I caught it in time.
In case no one knows, Rat Race Choir was the band at our wedding. And it was in Steve's best friend's backyard. And we didn't pick out any wedding song or anything because I don't want to be the center of attention. I'm not going to dance. And Steve's cousin, Debbie, said, no, you have to dance, you have to dance.
My cousin, Debbie, is
yes.
well, she's got, you know, she knows, she's the matriarch of the family now, and she's got all the Italian traditions down, and you have to dance.
Right, so Rat Race, without Steve, with one of Steve's students, played Whiter Shade of Pale,
that
because
was
it was
the
only
song.
Slow song they knew.
Because I think that day we were both a whiter shade of pale. But, so that was, yeah, that was
so
our
that was our
song.
Wedding song. And we didn't pick it out. I think Dave just played
I
it.
Think it just, I think they said play something slow.
Yeah.
And that's like,
they didn't
know,
even ask us. We didn't care.
Yeah. Could have been Rock the Casbah.
Ours was a very untraditional wedding.
It was a great wedding.
I didn't pick out any flowers because Steve's friend was going out with a florist, and she said, I want to gift you the
flowers.
So we're like,
thing.
Okay, whatever you want to do, do it. And she did a great job.
So it was like celebrity flowers everywhere.
Yeah, everywhere. She put real ones on the cake. We did pick out the flavor of the cake.
Yeah, we did well. Hello.
White cake with lemon
that
filling.
That was, man,
oh.
That was, and we did the thing where you take the top off and you save it for a year and eat it a year later.
And we did that. And
we
was,
did that and it was amazing.
It was fresh as the day we got married.
Yep.
So there you go, a little
yeah,
insight.
A little,
we got, our trivia. Wedding song was Whiter Shade of Pale.
Whiter Shade of Pale.
So every time I hear it, I'll go, oh, that's our wedding song.
Anyway.
Okay, so what are we doing?
I don't know, I gotta look.
Okay.
I gotta see.
Well, okay, so it would be Mark Visconti that asked for UK.
Oh, Mark Visconti. Okay,
and Anthony Gisondi asked for bringing home the bacon.
Well.
And Procol Harum.
Well, but that is Procol Harum. That would be the same thing, yeah.
But like other ones.
Okay, well, other ones.
You know.
Okay, well,
whatever you got.
I got bringing home the bacon. I got the bacon.
You got two songs for tonight?
I got four songs for tonight.
Okay. There you go. Oh, Sue saw UK in 1979 in New York City.
Yeah, we did. Well, I don't know if we saw the same show, but that's where we learned the songs before they released them on the album. That's why we were playing that stuff live before that album. Pat Romano, you want to check in on this,
well,
please?
Well, Silvio Anella says he was there also, and it was great.
Amazing.
At that same concert.
And I think they played stuff from the album that didn't come out yet, and we learned it.
Bet my dog that I have never seen them.
No, I'm pretty sure that you would know by the hospital
when
bill.
Rat Race would play UK, I thought it was a Rat Race original song, and I would head out to smoke a joint. Hey. If you played Funeral for a Friend, Love Lies Bleeding, Sarah Smile, Jethro Tull.
Okay.
I was there.
Jethro Tull, you were there?
Oh, I had Aqualung.
Aqualung?
Yes.
As opposed to Aqualung. Aqualung?
It's not the same thing?
Well, it is, but...
Aqualung.
Oh, now you're trying to slide the A.
I'm
bringing home the bacon.
All right, bring home the bacon,
I'm bringing
bitch.
It. Here it comes. Oh, look at that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Bringing home that bacon.
Bring that bacon home.
That's right.
It's funny. I look at those old pictures and it's like, wow. When did we do that?
Shit.
All of that. It's like it's another life. That whole thing. That whole 30, 29, whatever it was. Long time. I mean, it was a whole... I was looking at the pictures and I saw, can you name the three guitar players that were in those pictures, Pat? You're probably just going to guess and say.
Well, some people don't watch the show. They just listen while Pat they're doing stuff. Steve, your mic's off, Tom says. No, it's not, is it?
No.
I don't see it off.
Yeah, it's not off. Is it off?
It's not off. It's not off.
Okay, so now I don't even remember where I was. If my mic was off.
Who the guitar players were.
Oh, three guitar players. There was a picture of Bob Catapano.
Which I think that was before Pat's time. I think Bob Mayo was before Pat's time.
I don't know. Well, Bob Catapano was it 71 and 72?
So you had two Bobs.
Had two Bobs.
Right. Mark Visconti went Bob, Mark, and Bob.
Bob, Mark, and Bob, yes. Bob, Mark, and Bob sounds like a comedy routine. Mm. Hey, and now it's time for Bob, Mark, and Bob.
And Tom says, there it is, your mic.
Okay. Oh, well, okay, thank you. Tom, see, you can fix that stuff remotely, and I really do appreciate it, bro. I was actually bragging on you yesterday. I don't know if you saw yesterday's show. Jimmy Ryan, I was telling him to come in and see some real professional people on Friday.
That's right.
So, there's that.
We're proud of our...
Yeah, we are proud of our... Yeah.
Of our people.
You know, hey, man, if I'm in, I'm in wrists and ankles. That's just the way it goes. So, let's see.
Okay. So that one was for Anthony Gisondi and anyone else.
Anyone else that likes Procol Harum.
That's right.
And I tell you what, you know, going back to the studio today, transferring over this tape, I was telling you about the show from Dodge City, and for years, I only remember that one song, Had Enough, because we were laughing so hard in it, and I'm not sure if that's the version, if that's the song that we used on the live album, but we recut the vocals or something like that went down, because it was a great performance. But I never really listened to the rest of the show. I haven't listened to it probably. The last time I probably listened to it was when we were doing Deluxe, Left 4 Live Deluxe at Jim Roberts' studio. And I went in, you know, I start a... These stats are like the whole length of the show. It's just, you know, there's no ID numbers. It just runs like a cassette. So I just put the thing on autopilot and set a timer for as long as the set is, an hour and 45 or whatever, and then I go back in there and turn it off. So the alarm goes off and I walk in there and it's at the end of Dodge City, and I can't remember what, I think we ended with Heaven and Hell. We did, as a matter of fact. We ended that was the first incarnation of that set, was where we ended the night with Heaven and Hell. And John was singing pretty good. And then it goes into the Vampires thing or something like that. And at the end of Horror Rock, we go... real light, right? And the band's going... coming up underneath. I'm going, and it comes up to this big crescendo and it goes blam, and you hear and some guy I don't know who he was, I had never listened to it this far before, somebody got up on stage and said, "There's a new sheriff in town, and his name is John Entwistle." Now that, I mean...
Well, you know, he loved those cowboy movies John did.
He loved, well, we, you know.
He loved cowboy movies.
Entwistle didn't get up early for anything, except on the day after that show, we went down to Front Street, Dodge City. I mean,
yeah,
the real place.
To see and where the shootout at the OK Corral was?
I put him in the jail. They had a jail cell.
No, or was not, that no, a that, different no, town? No, that's, different cowboy
that's Tombstone.
Town. Tombstone.
You got your movies confused.
What happened in Dodge City?
Wyatt Earp was the sheriff there.
Oh, okay.
And, yeah.
Gotcha.
I mean, a lot of what happened in Dodge City? You're the cowboy person?
Well,
that was a story, though. No. All right, so anyway.
So is there really a tombstone?
Yeah. Is there a tombstone in Arizona?
Yeah.
Absolutely. I went from Winslow? No, I don't know. Yeah, there's tombstone.
Okay.
There's
but
Pooh
Dodge
Hill.
City is more famous.
Well, I don't
know. Oh, you know what? We were trying to
certainly
think.
Is now.
Ah, what about Bonanza? That was in... Where did we say it
Virginia
was?
City
Virginia
was the city,
city. But it wasn't Virginia.
Where no, I think it was Nevada. Virginia City, Nevada.
Nevada?
I think it was. Yeah, I think it was Nevada.
Yeah.
Nevada. Anybody have an opinion on that?
I could look it up.
Please don't. Because we live on Ponderosa, so it's, you know.
That's right. And we saw somebody with a bumper sticker the other day that said Ponderosa Ranch.
That's
oh,
right.
Tim McCullen, south of Tucson. So
it is?
It's in Arizona?
No, he's talking about, I think he's talking about Tombstone.
Oh, come on now. You have to, like, be more specific, people.
Yeah. See, and it's funny because, you know, in interviews, when you do an interview, they don't, the interviewer... You know, when it's just one of those talking head things, they ask you to repeat the question. So they say to you, so where did you grow up? And you're supposed to say, well, I grew up in White Plains, New York. So in this particular case, if you're answering a question that was asked 5 minutes ago, you need to let us know what the question was that you're answering. Otherwise... I mean, guys, we're challenged enough.
Okay. Well, so it is Virginia City, Nevada, bordering Lake Tahoe.
Thank you very much.
Uh-huh.
So how far from, not far from Reno? We did a show in Reno, man. Oh, it's never. Okay, so let's see. Where are we going next? Where
we're
going
to play another song.
I'll play another song.
Yeah.
I'm going to play another song.
Okay.
You watch me. I'm going to get ready to do it right now.
UK. Let's hear some UK.
What's some UK going? That's what you want?
This is for Mark Visconti,
okay,
one
Mark.
Of the children of the lawn.
Mark's in the house. Okay. That's fine.
He's not in the house. He's on the lawn.
He's on the lawn. Yeah, I got to get the new chairs out, too. They arrived, and I just, man, I've been so crazy with this other record and doing the Roy Orbison thing that I... And I'm falling behind on some of my chores, and I apologize. I really do. No,
okay, Sue
really
saw
don't.
Eno and Daryl Hall. Do you know who Eno is?
Brian Eno?
I have no idea.
Well, if that's who they're talking about, Brian Eno?
Have we talked about Brian Eno?
I don't think so.
No.
He was talking about us the other day.
Oh, no.
Brian Eno. All right, well, I don't know. So, what else?
We're going to play UK for Mark Visconti.
Oh, why don't we do that?
Yeah.
Okay.
We only
UK,
have 21
okay.
minutes left to the show.
How much?
21, and you got three songs to play.
Boy, I'm knit up, aren't I?
You better not.
All right, kids. Nope, wrong one. All right, we'll listen to this one.
What is this?
UK.
UK.
Thank you.
important milestone, and possibly the most important milestone in this entire sequence. Hey.
Thank you.
Oh, yes.
Okay, so let's see.
As far as the glitch in there, mm-hmm. or hack the show or whatever it was.
What was that?
That was, I don't know, something, either they used an old tape and all of a sudden that came through. I'm not really sure what that was, but okay, it's always been there. Okay. It'll always be there.
And we're not hacked. Okay, so Sue says Steve's hair is the same length as it is as now as in that video.
Is it on straight?
And Chris says, did you use Octobands?
Octobond. No. I had
Octobonds?
Those. No, Octobonds. That's what Stuart uses. Those the eight different. They're like 8-inch drums, long tubes, but they're all different lengths and they sound different.
Okay, and Lenny says that's crazy music.
Crazy music.
And then he says, "What's next, porno?" Because he thought that they were getting hacked.
Porno?
Nope.
There, I'll give you some porno. You know what? I got a great picture of Lori that you're gonna want to see.
This is being shown in a cafe.
Yes, Kane's Cafe.
There she is
over there. That'll be Lori. You can tell by the keyboard. That's as close to porn as it gets here, Lenny.
Kane's Cafe
Where Angus lives.
Yes.
Is it Kane's Cafe?
Yeah,
Kane's. Hi, guys, at Kane's Cafe.
Yeah.
They were wondering Kane's if we were
Cafe.
Talking to them. We were talking to you, Dr. Clockus. Told us that he went in there the other day and you guys blew his mind, so...
Yeah, they said, Dr. Clockus. That's funny.
You can't make this stuff up. All right, so, you can have one from column A. I don't have enough time for both songs. You can have one from column A or one from column B. You can have Rat Race playing an obscure Procol Harum song with old pictures, or you can have Alaska.
Okay, Mark Visconti wants to know, how many kits did you use in all of your years in Rat Race?
Well, not that many. In fact, and I'll tell you, I'll tell you.
But Donald wants to hear something from column B.
What was that, UK?
I don't know. Keith Crane says Alaska.
Okay. I think it's Alaska.
Hi,
anyway,
Keith. Didn't know you were
there.
Yeah,
hey, Keith. Okay, so I started out with a double set of Slingerland Sparkling Champagne, inspired by the one and only Dino Danelli. And from that, I started adding stuff. I had Timbales, and I was, trying to expand the kit. And the next kit that I bought was in 1971, which was a 7-piece Fives kit. And that was pretty much the only kit that I used. It was two up, two down, two kicks, snare drum, cymbal, And eventually I wanted to go to the Octa Plus, which is 6, 8, 10, 12, 13, the ones, the concert toms. And so that was the blue ones that you saw in that video, the blue translucent, Vistalite, clear blue tom-toms. But that was the same set. That was the five set. And then I ran into a nefarious character who actually put together the matching tom-toms from the five set that you saw there. And that was my kit through most of Rat Race.
Rat Race.
What?
That's what he wanted to know.
The only other kit that I ever used with Rat Race was the Remo kit. That I first used with Entwistle.
And Paul Cooper says North.
North drums, yeah. Yeah, but they were all added. It was all added on that same, those same Fives bass drums and snare drum. It was all built around, and floor toms. It was all built around that kit from 71. So.
Okay, well.
So what, it's what, column B was what? That was UK?
They want to hear Alaska.
Want to hear Alaska. All right, hold on, I'll ask her. Oh, you get it. Is this, this is, no, that's not Alaska. That's the only thing she needs. You want to hear that? We just played Alaska.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, Alaska was this one.
Okay, let's play
this
Alaska.
This is Alaska. Here, this is Alaska.
That's how much attention you people are paying.
This is Alaska.
I don't know what's what with these songs.
This is the only thing she needs. All right, so wait. Look, I want to be fair about this.
Lindy's saying, Procol Harum.
Procol Harum? Will that work for everybody? Good.
Everybody else is saying the other thing. I don't know.
Everybody else, well, it would be that. It wouldn't be Alaska, because Alaska was the first one in the other one, Dead of Night and Alaska.
Okay.
This is the only thing she needs.
He already played Alaska.
All right, so we've got the only thing she needs or Pandora's box.
And he says, again, this is crazy music.
It's crazy music.
Why is it crazy, Lenny?
Because it's all... Blah, 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 blah. Sounds like somebody put an egg beater in their mouth and was whistling. You know what? I'm going to save the only thing she needs, and I'm going to play Pandora's Box by Procol Harum with this stunning picture array, so you can see all the sets.
Is it going to send me out of the room?
I hope so. I mean, I hope not. Anyway, yeah, this is that.
Okay.
So, yeah, Procol Harum.
There you go.
Oh, there you go. Oh, look at that. I guess.
Okay, so that would conclude Anything Goes Wednesday.
Yeah, and I'm sorry that you about the Alaska mix up. But I'll save the only thing she needs. It's a great cut of it, and I'll save that the next time you request UK.
Well, we have next Wednesday.
There's always next Wednesday.
Okay, so then tomorrow night we have
Steve Gaspar, right? Oh, what? Who? What?
Why don't you just tell him what he does and where he's from? Go ahead. Keyboard player for the Hollywood All Stars. Steve Gaspar.
That's it?
Yes. So if we don't see you in the future...
We'll see you in... What?
Take my line, I'll take yours.
All right. Is that how it's going? Anyway, thanks for all you do. If I don't see you in the future, I'll see you in the pasture.
Good night, everybody.